Unit 8. Listening. Exercise 2. Speaker 1.
I can't believe I missed my big chance. I wish I'd tried harder.
Speaker 2.
What a day. I've got no energy left at all. Thank goodness it's the weekend.
Speaker 3.
I'm determined to work hard and be a success in my chosen career.
Speaker 4.
I'm happy in my job. It's hard work, but it's worth it for the benefits we get.
Speaker 5.
I know I'll do well at the interview because I've got the qualifications and the experience.
2. You hear two people talking about a job interview.
Hey, congratulations! I hear you've got an interview with that law firm.
Thanks, yes. I'm not very confident of getting the job, though.
Why not? You've got all the qualifications, haven't you? It's perfect for you. Are you worried that you won't answer the interviewer's questions well enough?
Well, that's never easy. But I've had plenty of practice and feel quite confident about that. I just get the feeling that they're looking for someone who's been doing the job for several years. I'm fairly new to it, and that's not going to work in my favour.
I'm sure you'll be great in the interview, and they'll realise you'll do a fantastic job. Don't worry.
3. You hear a woman talking.
I decided to retire from my job last year because I wanted to spend more time with my grandchildren before they grow up. I can't say I was sorry to say goodbye to the people I worked with. They were a rather unpleasant bunch, very secretive and envious of other people's salaries, which was silly, really, because it's not as if any of us were earning very much. I was sad to lose the main perk of the job, though, which was free drinks and snacks every day. The cost of food shopping really does add up and takes a good chunk out of my pension. Still, it's worth it to be able to see my grandchildren.
4. You hear two people talking about jobs.
There are two jobs here in the paper I'm thinking of applying for. This building company wants a full-time electrician, but if I take that, I'll never be able to finish the work I'm doing on my daughter's house.
Are you thinking of just getting a part-time job then?
Well, maybe yes. There's one here that's 30 hours a week, which would be ideal, but I'm not sure I could live on the amount I'd earn from that. If I took the full-time one, my wages would be much higher.
Well, of course. And the part-time one's miles away, look. You'd take forever to get there and back.
5. You hear a woman talking.
I love my job. I look after old people in a nursing home. It's true that by the end of each day I can hardly move because I'm so tired. But I don't really mind because I know I'm helping people. My cousin earns twice what I do. She's a top lawyer. But if I had to cope with as much stress as her, I'd probably quit my job after a few weeks. My job's quite fun, really. Sometimes I feel a bit sorry for the old people. But the good thing is we're making their lives as good as we possibly can. So it's a happy place, really.
6. You hear a student talking.
I was very disappointed when I finished school because I didn't do well enough to get into Oxford University, where I'd always hoped to go. Most of my friends are there. So at first, I felt like a failure compared to them. However, I chose a course at a well-respected business school instead, so that when I leave, I'll hopefully be equipped to become a top businessman and make a fortune. That should impress the Oxford guys, even if it's not exactly what Mum and Dad had in mind for me. If I start making big profits in a few years, though, I'm sure they won't be complaining.
7. You hear a woman talking.
I've been working at this advertising agency for over 6 months, but if nothing changes, I won't be staying here much longer. I took the job because I wanted to work my way up into a much more senior position. I'm very ambitious, you see. I'm determined that if I work really, really hard, I can be very successful and maybe even own my own company one day. But here, they don't care about helping you to develop your career, and I'll just be stuck in this boring, dead-end office assistant job forever. It's a shame, because it's a fantastic company, but I'm going nowhere. Time to move on.